SBS acknowledges the traditional custodians of country and their connections and continuous care for the skies, lands and waterways across Australia.
You're listening to Australia Explained, an SBS audio podcast helping you navigate life in Australia.
Warning: this content contains details about a domestic violence crime that may be confronting or distressing.
Welcome to this special episode of Australia Explained. Today, we'll explore how we can help raise children to be respectful partners.
Regardless of where you live, your educational background, your cultural background, what you do for work and what your position is in a particular community, you need to acknowledge that family domestic violence exists in every community.
You'll meet three guests who share both personal and deep insights on this issue. Whether you are a parent or family member, learn what to look out for and how and why to talk with young people about respect.
There's a lot of work to be done. I think there needs to be very strong education and awareness campaigns starting at a much younger age. The messaging needs to come across about healthy relationships very early in life. Our kids are starting relationships in primary school.
Domestic violence doesn't begin with a single act of physical harm. It often starts with signs of disrespect, control, and emotional abuse that can go unnoticed or unaddressed. Stopping domestic violence isn't just about reacting to the worst-case scenarios. It's about preventing them before they grow into something more serious. Arman Abrahimzadeh is an Adelaide-based anti-domestic violence campaigner and an advocate for preventing domestic violence. His mission is inspired by a personal tragedy.
My journey really started at a young age when I started to see violence and abuse being a normal and frequent thing that happened in my household. It essentially got us to a point where in my early 20s, we were threatened by my dad. He essentially said that he would lock us all in the house and kill us. We found ourselves in a position where we made a decision to pack our bags and leave the family home because we didn't want to take that risk. And once we fled the family home, for me personally, I thought that that was the end of the difficult times.
But it wasn't. Mr. Abrahimzadeh believed that leaving a home where threats were commonplace and physical abuse occurred regularly would signify the beginning of a new chapter and the end of living in perpetual fear for their safety.
When we fled the family home, we faced homelessness, poverty, and isolation. We managed to get through that, and we essentially got to the point where 12 months after fleeing the abusive home, my mum and my older sister decided to attend a Persian New Year function. It was at the Adelaide Convention Centre. This was in March 2010. And without any of us knowing, my dad also showed up at the function. That was the place where he decided to essentially stab her to death in front of about 300 witnesses.
He says that in today's Australia, the rates of family and domestic violence are alarming. And in the majority of cases, the perpetrators are current or former partners. Therefore, it's about time that we highlight the underlying causes that lead to domestic violence and try to prevent it before it happens by looking for the early warning signs.
Those early warning signs could be anything from gender stereotypes to intimidating, controlling behavior to some of those disrespectful attitudes that exist in our community. And sometimes it can be propelled by online content or certain jokes or certain behaviors and attitudes that we see in our community.
Mr. Abrahimzadeh spent years turning his pain into purpose, advocating for change and focusing on how we can raise our children to be respectful and empathetic partners. Drawing from his own experience and reflecting on his memories, Mr. Abrahimzadeh says that driving change can start from our homes. It's about modeling respect at home. He believes that young people tend to mimic the behavior they see in their family homes, adopt it, and consider it normal. Conversations about empathy, respect, and equality should be part of everyday life.
As a young boy, I looked up to my dad, and when I saw my dad treat my mum in a particular way, I essentially adopted and I learned it. It was a normal thing and it was an automatic thing for me. It got to the point where once my father ended up killing my mother, that I started to reflect on all of those behaviors, which included the way my dad talked to my mum, treated my mum, and what the family dynamic looked like in my family home.
Jatinder Kaur is the director of JK Diversity Consultants and an accredited mental health social worker who specializes in working with migrant and refugee communities in Australia. She agrees that the way parents treat each other and the people around them can have a strong impact on growing minds.
How are the parents communicating with each other? How are they demonstrating respectful relationships and having conversations and not displaying aggressive behaviors or undermining or abusive or emotionally harmful behaviors? So healthy relationships really does start at the home. Yes, social media plays a part, school influence plays a part, and this is across all cultures, not just migrant and refugee cultures. Young children observe and learn from their parents.
Ms. Kaur also explains how some hidden forms of disrespect that young people encounter online might influence their behaviors.
Young people spend a lot of their time on scrolling, whether it's on Instagram, TikTok, any of those social media platforms. And for teenagers, their brains are impressionable. It is actually a developing brain. So what they are consuming then becomes their source of knowledge. And if that information is inaccurate or is focused on false information or certain biases or promoting certain disrespectful beliefs, then for young people, they can start to think that that's normal because that's what they are seeing and watching and consuming.
Danny Mikati is a former sergeant in the New South Wales Police Force. After years of service, he started working in the domestic violence unit. It was during this time that he witnessed the impact of domestic violence on the community. Mr. Mikati emphasizes the important role of parents and educators in fostering a culture of respect, not just in real life, but also online. He believes this is crucial in a world where harmful influences, both online and offline, affect young people.
Parents have no choice but to have at least a basic awareness and understanding of social media. Their children are going to be using it for the rest of their life. Australia is one of those countries that has a very high uptake of social media. Most of our kids by far are on at least one or two different social media platforms. So parents need to understand the dangers.
He believes that modern technologies can facilitate disrespectful and abusive behaviors, making them easily accessible at anyone's fingertips.
Almost everybody has a mobile phone. There's different ways of using cyber techniques. You can sort of stalk your partner. You can see what they're up to. So it becomes a lot more prevalent. Now you can now bully someone or harass someone 24/7 by using their devices.
Mr. Mikati says that prevention is key. It involves showing young people what healthy relationships look like before harmful behaviors take root.
We can't always just create more DV refuges, even though obviously there's a need. But if we're always only addressing the reaction or the consequences, we never actually target the core fundamental leading or causative strategies.
He highlights some of the initiatives implemented by the Australian government to combat domestic violence and prevent it at its roots within communities, especially the recent campaign, Stop It at the Start.
Stop It at the Start campaign is the primary prevention campaign to counter all sort of toxic masculinity messages that are flowing around, especially in recent times throughout social media.
Ms. Kerr is a proud supporter of the Stop It at the Start campaign as a multicultural influencer. She says it's important to understand the cultural norms and expectations of migrants and refugees during their settlement journey in Australia.
If they come from very traditional values and beliefs, those traditions may not reflect the societal norms that exist within the Australian community. If I look back at some of my experience with different generations that have come to Australia, the notion of respect and how patriarchy works. In some cultures, women may not have an equal say in the household and may not be treated equally.
So how can we balance existing traditional values or community expectations and be able to guide children towards healthy relationships? Ms. Kerr advises that it can begin by creating an environment for open conversations and asking questions.
If we have parents who might be quite authoritarian, very strict based on their culture or religion, and have a very particular parenting style, then what we typically see is those young people won't ask those questions of their parents. They will then most likely go to their peers or online to get the support that they want. So a big challenge for us as professionals in our sector is trying to assist our migrant and refugee parents to better educate them in changing some of their parenting styles and also adopting maybe a more of a flexible approach in how they communicate with their children and teenagers.
She adds that an effective way for communities to help prevent domestic violence and address it before it begins is by recognizing abusive and gender-based violent behaviors and refusing to remain passive bystanders.
We need to recognize that that is inappropriate behavior and that is not accepted in Australia. Then as a bystander, we call it out, or we require to assist, we refer them to an appropriate service. I think the time has already passed that we need both men and women and community leaders to all be on the same page when it comes to addressing issues around gender-based violence.
Mr. Ibrahimzadeh had a terrible story to share, losing his mom to domestic violence. But this has made him even more aware of what he can now do to promote equality in his own home.
Now that I have a wife and I've got two young boys of my own, I want to make sure the role model that I am and the sorts of behaviors and attitudes that I show in my family home are being adopted by my young son, because as the research shows, they'll go and replicate that behavior in their own relationships and their own family homes.
The Stop It at the Start campaign offers resources for community members in languages other than English. For more information, visit respect.gov.au/translated. If you or someone you know is impacted by sexual assault or domestic or family violence, call 1800 RESPECT on 1-800-737-732 or Lifeline on 13 11 14. Thank you for listening to this special episode of Australia Explained, produced in partnership with Stop It at the Start, an Australian government initiative.
This was an SBS audio podcast. For more Australia Explained stories, visit sbs.com.au/Australia Explained.
Subscribe or follow the Australia Explained podcast for more valuable information and tips about settling into your new life in Australia. Do you have any questions or topic ideas? Send us an email to australiaexplained@sbs.com.au.